It's time for the Weather Authority forecast, and so much of the focus over the next couple of days is truly going to be sucked up by this storm, Hurricane Dorian. There are new numbers just in, but I'm looking at all of the news websites from the west coast of Florida. The St. Augustine Record, and some people who vacation down in Florida, that may be the newspaper that you read. And this, Josh, always strikes me because we cover this from such a broad perspective, and we know that the national networks will cover this. But in St. Augustine, the St. Johns County Council on Aging, they run something called the Sunshine Bus Service. It's not going to run until at least the middle of next week. This is the sort of impact that there is on people's everyday lives.
Yeah. I mean, I grew up going down to Daytona Beach where I had some family for the years in the 90s and 2000s. And, you know, many times these storms end up kind of turning to the north, but until they do.
Well, who knows? Yeah.
It's still days out. At least they have the preparation
time.
Versus like a severe thunderstorm or a tornado. So here's the latest, though, on Dorian. I can tell you this. No change since the 11 a.m. advisory by the National Hurricane Center. Let's take that graphic full screen if we could. You can see here. Basically, the map is showing the storm on the right side of the screen. Florida is on the left side of the screen. And the winds, look at this, 115 miles per hour. That's sustained. That's the minimum for a Category 3, a.k.a. a major hurricane. There it is, just churning away. You can see there's a little bit of shear on the southern end of the storm there, kind of a sharp cutoff of the clouds. But right here, the Bahamas, and they actually have hurricane warnings. They're going to see some winds out of this storm, definitely, as the storm heads further to the west. This is the latest National Hurricane Center forecast. Note closely how it's more of a westerly position or track versus north. And it looks like here, as we go through time, say Sunday morning, it's kind of getting through the Bahamas here, Sunday evening, Sunday night, into Monday morning, it's approaching somewhere east, southeast side of Florida coast as a Category 4. Wind speeds could approach 140 miles per hour. So please check back with us tonight. You can also track Hurricane Dorian, on your smartphone with our Weather Authority app as well. The planner back home for tomorrow for the state fair, day 11, 60s, 50s in the morning, and then back up in the low 70s by afternoon. A nice breeze, similar to what we had earlier this afternoon. It's 74 right now in Syracuse, 75 Utica, Rome. Live triple Doppler radar is nice and quiet. No precip tonight, and nothing as we head into tomorrow either. Our future cast, maybe some patchy morning fog. Otherwise, I think it's going to be a nice, pleasant, nice feel to the air all day long. If you're heading out to the fair tomorrow, beautiful. If you have any other weekend plans, Saturday looks like the drier of the two weekend days. So tonight, 55 should do it here in Syracuse. Cool for most, chilly for some of our rural areas that may get down the 40s. Again, that patchy valley fog, you may have to deal with some of that. Tomorrow afternoon, room temperature, 72 degrees, blue sky, sunshine, a few clouds, cooler than it was, say, today. But with the breeze, I still think overall a great day, especially in the weekend here. 7-day outlook here for Sunday, some afternoon showers after a quiet morning for the first day of September 2019. Labor Day looks okay, a morning shower, afternoon, drier weather, 75. Warmer Tuesday back in the 80s, and then cooling back off to near 70 towards the middle of the next week.
Thank you, Josh. Coming up.